Greetings, everyone, and welcome. I'm the Chancellor of Soul, Mike Boone. You've tuned in to a two-parter show on Soul Facts. The Johnny H. Story, Part 2. From 1952 to 1953, Johnny Ace became one of the most celebrated R&B artists during the early portion of the 1950s. You are to me. Now with continuing hits in motion, the road became Johnny Ace's home with a demanding $350 a year per concert. On tour, Johnny was full of energy with his childlike ways, as his former guitarist Milton Hopkins described in the Houston Chronicle. Johnny's idea of having fun was driving his Oldsmobile 90 miles per hour with his .22 pistol in hand, shooting out the zeros on the roadside speed limit signs. Ace purchased the .22 caliber revolver through another artist while performing in Tampa, Florida. Some of this life-filled energy would soon become tragic. On December 25, 1954, at a Negro Christmas dance at the City Auditorium in Houston, Texas, Johnny wowed the audience, a capacity of 3,000, with his rendition of Yes Baby Yes, along with Big Mama Thornton. After the show, Ace was sitting backstage with his girlfriend Olivia Gibbs and Big Mama. Now here's a recount on the tragic event. Johnny was in a playful mood and with his .22 began pointing the gun at everyone. Now a day before, Ace was shooting the gun out the window at the auditorium, annoying everyone in the area, where they started to complain later on. On this day, Johnny repeated the same antics where it irritated Big Mama Thornton so much she took the gun away from him. But a smooth Ace managed to coax the gun away from her. Again, Johnny renewed his playful antics and pointed the gun at Big Mama Thornton, which she told him not to. Then Ace pointed the gun toward his girlfriend Olivia Gibbs, with Big Mama screeching at him, "Someday you're gonna kill somebody with that thing." Johnny reassured Big Mama that it was okay and there's no bullets in the gun, and then proceeded to aim the gun at his temple. He then pulled the trigger and Johnny Ace was dead. The rumors of Johnny Ace playing Russian roulette were false. Ace, being playful and irresponsible, accidentally killed himself. There were also rumors of him being murdered because of the ownership of his songwriting publishings were also false. The stories were so advertising, Don Robey let it continue as a marketing play for his record sales. To capitalize on Johnny Ace's legacy, Don Robey got Ace's younger brother St. Clair Alexander to record as Buddy Ace. When St. Clair didn't work out, Robey later recruited singer Jimmy Lee Land as a recurrent Buddy Ace. Johnny Ace was laid in state on January 2nd, 1955 at Claiborne Temple Church AME in his hometown in Memphis, Tennessee. It was attended by 5,000 mourners. Forever, my darling. His last masterpiece recording, Pledging My Love, Back With Any More, became Johnny's number one posthumous R&B hit, lingering for 10 weeks on the charts in February 1955. Hood You My Love was recorded with Johnny Otis and his orchestra. His label Duke released a single version including pop background singers for crossover appeal.
Forever, my darling, my love will be true, always and forever, I'll love just you. Now, darling.
The label also released a tribute album entitled Johnny Ace Memorial LP, compiling his hits from 1952 to 1955.
And I've always been real true.
Over the years, the LP would enjoy countless reissues and sales. There have been many accolades and tributes to the late great Johnny Ace by various artists, including Aretha Franklin's heartfelt sofa remake of Ace's My Song, the B-side to her A-side hit, Seesaw.
You told me that you would leave me here in tears.
Her version charted number 10 R&B on January 4th, 1969.
Now you're gone and our words seem like.
Other musical accolades and tribute to Johnny by various artists included the Teen Queen's classic 1956 hit, Eddie My Love, was originally titled Johnny My Love in tribute to Ace, but was later changed. Bob Dylan and Joan Baez's performance of Johnny's Never Let Me Go on their Rolling Thunder Review Tour in 1975. Elvis Presley covered a version of Pledge My Love, featured on his last recording LP, Moody Blue, released in July of 1977. Paul Simon composed and performed The Late Great Johnny Ace, featured in his Hearts and Bones LP, released in 1983. And at 12 years of age, late singer Lou Reed wore a black armband when hearing of Johnny Ace's death.
Don't make me wait too long.
Johnny Ace conceived the fashion and formation of early quintessential R&B. His emotional consistency in his vocals planted a seed where his musical roots upsprung a futuristic, groundbreaking genre called soul.
Forever, my darling, my love will be true.
Johnny's style has influenced a generation of up-and-coming artists. His legacy continues to be appreciated and preserved by legions of true, worthy fanatics across the globe. Let's just be thankful that the music outlives the man. I'm the Chancellor of Soul.
Forever burn. My heart's at your command, dear, to keep love. Making you happy is my desire, dear. Keeping you is my goal.
Soul Facts, a show written, created, produced, and copywritten by the Chancellor of Soul, Mike Boone. Soul Facts is a non-profit organization show.